They got two big graders they're trying to back into them to stop them with. And they're squirting gas in there and they're shooting them with high-powered rifles.
Hello, my name is Marvin Heeymeyer. Today is, April 13th, 2004. I'm living in Granby, Colorado. And this tape is about my life since I came up here to Granby in 1991.
Yep, here he comes out to the street.
Scott, if you need
he is definitely still running.
If you need to get to someplace safe, we understand.
The whole top of his thing is completely covered with bricks and building material. And now he's turning straight towards me, coming back to Main Street.
Well, Scott, we want you to be safe if you need to go.
We're backing up.
Are you far enough away that you're safe, Scott?
Well, depending on what he's got in there.
I think God will bless me to get the machine done, to drive it, to do the stuff that I have to do up to a point, and then the machine will do one of two or three times. You're either going to blow me right off the streets, I'm going to have a heart attack and die because I'm all pumped up. The machine's going to break. Or maybe it'll go all day and I'll run out of fuel. I don't know. I got a lot of fuel in that thing, let me tell you. So I'm trying to be as prepared as I can be to do what I believe needs to be done, what God has inspired me to do. And we'll see once where it goes.
But yeah, I can see it now. You know what? It looks like a locomotive. He's got so much stuff on it. He's got a stack on the front for the exhaust to come out. He's got gun turrets. He's even got the tracks covered up. I mean, this guy... Like I said, somebody spent months and months and months to make this vehicle to do exactly what he's doing.
You know? Because it definitely is in God's hands. It is not in my hands. Without a doubt, I'm building it. But there's a reason why I am successful at continuing this project.
To this moment, can you give us an idea of the damage that this man has caused so far in the town?
Yeah, it looks like he drove through the cement plant, drove through a concrete form plant, completely wiped out town hall, and then took out the newspaper office, and now he's attacking XL Energy's gas office.
You meddled in my business and took what I deserved away. You took advantage of my good nature. And another thing you should learn is that when you visit evil upon someone, be assured it will revisit you. And that is what is happening.
Describe it for us, because when someone says bulldozer to us, you see a large machine with a front-loading bucket.
Right. Think of the biggest bulldozer you've ever seen in your life with the blade on the front completely covered up with steel.
Wow. Steel plating, in other words, correct?
What, excuse me?
You're saying steel plating.
You could tell somebody spent months and months and months getting this thing ready.
Because I think the community of Granby will be stronger. I think that they will understand after years, if they ever hear this tape, if they ever hear the truth, if they're ever willing to listen.
We understand some of the targets. It appears that he has specific targets. It's not just building after next to each other.
He took out the buildings he wanted to. He took out the paper office. He took out town hall and quite a few vehicles there. He got a few vehicles at the newspaper office. Took out the cement plant and a concrete form plant right next to that.
So Scott, when you say took out, how much damage has there been done to these buildings?
Totals the buildings.
So the buildings are
shot right there.
The buildings are on the ground. Is that correct?
Yep.
I spent the whole summer of 2003 in that friggin' building, lived there without a shower for as much as four days at a time, working on that dozer, getting it prepared to do what I have to do. And it was, that's another thing that was so uncanny. Talk about getting caught. Why didn't I get caught? Why haven't I been caught? Or why didn't I get caught up to now?
So finally got them blocked in with these road graders.
So as best as you can tell, police have him surrounded and stopped at the moment.
Let's see here. Oh, I can see an XL truck standing clear on its end, completely pinched in half against the building.
They are firing some shots.
Yeah, there goes another shot. They got a really big, high-powered rifle they're trying to pierce the metal with.
Exactly. Are you across the street?
Yeah, I'm like a half a block away.
Oh, my gosh. You're very close.
How come they didn't catch me? It was right there under their nose. Well, I wasn't supposed to get caught. Not yet. Maybe I will. Maybe this whole thing will come to stop early. That's the way it's supposed to be. I will accept that.